So, hello people. It's day 14 of 11 of Code. We are gonna get the puzzle in half a minute. So, let's get ready for it. So, what's it gonna be today? Graphs, assembly. What's it gonna be? Disk fragmentation. Sure, so we are gonna use day 10. Used squares. Right, so we are counting ones. So So I think we're gonna use compute one. So let's say what does it end with? String. Hash. So now we can use something like this. So the input is string. The output is integer. Input is like this. Example. Example is like, oops, is like this. We do nothing in bars, so the output here is this. Okay. So let's start the watcher. Compute input. What? What's wrong? Input a string. And the output is integer. What? Here input is list of integers, output 2 is All right. Okay, so so we have to do it a bit differently. How can we? Okay, let's see the day 10 again. Hello, Grisel. So we have to convert our number into well, no, I'm not. I'm looking at day 10 because I will be using it in the day 14, which I haven't started yet. Yes. Okay, so string. Give me just a second. My cat is doing something weird. Okay, so was it to code or something different? To code, okay. Is it okay now? I'm not sure if it maybe it's not working because I am importing another day in there. No, I'm not sure. We'll see. So, now inputs are key string dash a number. So compute input integer and it's weird that it's somehow using the day 10, like showing it here. Not sure what's going on, but okay, this is all right. Now Okay, so I think we only have to convert it to bits. Thirty two hexadecimal digits, each of these corresponds to 4 bits, right? So, do we have something like can we do something like this? If I just put 0x in front, okay, this works. So I know I used this library. I think I'll roll my own. It will be easier. So, this is a string. Binary, so we get a string, we should get not hash and string into a list of booleans. So hash string to list, list concat map, so character list of booleans to bin char is okay. I will make it be a list of integers to be a bit faster. So A, B, C, D, A, F, and whatever else is an error. So we should what? Crash. I am slow today. So let's see. There's nothing. Oh, snap. Okay. And now, so let's see the 0000, right? The next is 0101. Okay, this seems okay. List. So maybe let's just count. And it'll be 0. Okay, so no, it is not just it isn't just like converting the character to integer. This reminds me of the book Hacker's Delight, which is full of C expressions for like count the number of ones in this, and it uses some like bitwise logic magic that does it, and I don't understand at all. So debug crash. List some, so let's see. It's slow. Okay, so something's wrong. Yeah, that's for sure. So let's try again. Let's see it. It stops at 127. So why is it wrong? Let's just try. To visualize it. So, hashes and dots is and character to hashes and dots will be So it's basically what I just did a few moments before, but I thought my solution will be correct. So that's unfortunate. Come on. So visualize hashes and dots, string join and like this. It should return string. It should crash. We don't care about the types right now. So what's 6 7? What could be there? So we did not hash it. It is hello, and it is always transpiled to JavaScript, and I run it on Node, or you can run it in the browser. Yeah. Oops. Okay. So, now let's compare. So, this seems the same. I'm not sure why it is not. Okay, so it seems to be right. So why is it not? Used squares. So 3 is 0, used is 1. Let's just try to run it, try the output, we'll see. Not the right answer. Okay. So I'm not really sure what to do. Let's see. Let's see if the hash gets converted all right. So hashes and dots. So okay, this has to be here. So it's like this, and so this is AOC2017, right? So, React plus Flow plus ES6, like it's solid. Like, I haven't used Flow much, but I have used it a bit more than TypeScript. So basically, Flow and TypeScript try to give JavaScript some of the like type safety, compile time errors as opposed to runtime errors, but it still is the JavaScript, like with all its warts and so on. So it's better, it's definitely step in the right direction, but like to me Elm seems where it's headed, only it has different syntax. So maybe Reason ML it's also statically typed. It looks more like JavaScript, and it's basically where these tools are trying to get JavaScript to. So, it has real nice like compiler errors. You can just, if you're refactoring, you can be sure it remembers all the like you have to change it up here, 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 here. And I'm not gonna compile until you do. You can change up model type and then just let the compiler give you list of stuff to fix, like to change the usages. So it's nice, it's definitely nice. And React with Redux is basically the Elm architecture. Like you have a state, you have a set of messages, and you just get a message and the current state and spit out the next state, and that's how Elm works. So Redux was inspired by that, and yeah, like I like both. I like React with Redux more than just rolling your own JavaScript and like doing it without any architecture. But if I can, I do it in Clojure. I do have some Clojure experience, but I like stopped somewhere around reagent. I didn't really use OHM. So ClojureScript is more closely tied to JavaScript. It has, seamless interop. It's basically different syntax with macros and so on. Elm is really a different beast, and if you want to talk to JavaScript, you have to go through like customs border. So, it might be easier to work with JavaScript, with ClojureScript, but it has less safety and refactoring ease and so on. And also, they released spec with which I don't know, I haven't used it. It might give ClojureScript the type safety. So, yeah. It's like type safety is kind of my like main point of why am I using Elm. Oh, Gracil, that's interesting. It like from what I know, Reason ML is kind of like just different syntax for OCaml or some ML language. So does spec use only runtime checking, or can you like run it in advance? What can I do here? So back to the puzzle. So, I don't know what's wrong. Okay, let's see the sums again. So, right. 6 might be 6 might be 2. 6 is proper 2. That should be an error, right? I hope. Okay. So, yeah, I'm stupid. I could have been a lot faster with this. So, core types, yeah, I kind of tried core type, but it doesn't seem nice to use. Like I kind of gave up after trying it for a while. But I can't put it into words like why. I'm not sure myself, but it just didn't click with me. So, but I also felt similar way when trying to use flow. So I don't know, maybe it doesn't let me, or I'm not experienced enough to express some types in the flow or core typed specification. I don't know. So Lisp and static typing. Well, there are some static type Lisps, but yeah, it's like Shen or something, but it's more common to be dynamic. Okay, number of regions. Right. So we have to work. We have to work with like both horizontal and vertical connection. It would be easier if it was only horizontal. 1 2 4 2. 1 2 4 2. So grid of hexes. Input. Right. So, how to do this? I could put it into a grid. So, array of arrays. So will this be nicer? Get location, set location. Let's try this one. So import metrics, and now metrics, what character? No metrics. Matrix Boolean. Okay, so I will have to do the booleans anyway. True. False, false. No. Hex to binary. So I'm not sure, like there's no, I think there's no like function in the core. Yeah, sure. Yeah, I understand you, but I'm not sure of like the, I'm not aware of any like function that would do it. So, I roll my own for, you know, speed. Maybe the reason is not in the library is that it's not very common task in Elm World, you know, like we also shun like using booleans in function parameters because we can do like type has logged in is, you know, so that it has some meaning or it can have some data. So yeah, we kind of don't work with like bit flags and so on. So character to booleans, so to matrix is hexes bools and bools will return right. So this is the rows and now let's from lists, okay. And I'm now using unsafe maybe so often that let's put it into, let's put it into the library for all the programs. Okay. So to matrix okay, so it kind of works. And now, come on. I know you want to be fat, but I have to work now. So, connected regions. Do they call it regions? Regions, right. So up list of come on. Ah, is this what you want? Come on. So I will have to. So, how to do this? Let's find like a dictionary, like graph could be a nice way to do this. So I'm thinking of actually using graph and using the connected components. Strongly connected components. Well, not the search algorithm, but I want to connect the ones to each other and then just count the number of groups. Do I not? Let's keep it there. Well, I can make it directed in both ways, right? Let's just see. So, Graysal, do you think it will not work with like edge is like two edges, one there and one back? Yeah, that's what I want. I think. Like in my head, it makes sense. DFS or BFS? So, how would they work? Visits all components. So I will not work. I will not see that yet. I want to like solve it, but let's see. DFS. So does it see all? It does. Okay. Let's see. Zert. Right, sure. So, yeah, like my concern somewhere in the back of my head was like does it visit all nodes or just starting from the one that I start with? Does it find all in that group and then I have to do something else for each one of those? So if the FS actually visits all the nodes, even if they are not connected somehow, that's great. So it only visits the one in the same component you started with. So do I make a list of positions out of that component? Yeah, that's what I was thinking, right? Make notes, make no context. So so this is now list of booleans. Okay, so let's see. So if no nodes are empty, right? So I'm not sure into like appends. Graph, right? Right, sure. Yeah, so it makes them compatible with each other, as they are both collections, right? Okay, let's continue. Grid. Index map, index map, and now this is y, this is x, right. So y and row I think that's right. So this is a list of booleans. Integer boolean, and we want to create node context. So node node and node ID. Okay, so let's just do whatever. And the value is boolean. Okay, so in the dictionary, and can I somehow okay, so I think I'll have to use indict so we are here and edges will be edges will be so we have to get the neighbors, which is left, right, up and bottom. List filter map identity, so we will be we'll be using maybe for this. So left, right, top, bottom, and left is if x greater than 0, then something else, nothing. So yeah, and get with x minus 1 0 is not false, right? Geospa, hello. It's elementary OS, so it kind of looks, it wants to look like Mac OS, I guess, or like be as usable as one. And theme, I'm not sure. Like the terminal has some theme, I do not have a theme in Vim. It kind of looks like Solarized, but we already talked a few days later, a few days before, that it isn't Solarized, so I'm not really sure. You can try to find it on their GitHub, maybe it has a name. So just ID of x minus 1 and y. So right is x is not 127, x plus 1, all right, and y. You're welcome. X plus 1. Top, so if y is not 0, x, y, minus 1, and bottom right, so that should be it. Now get, so it gets grid, so which is okay, so this is a list, so let's at least make a race out of it. So grid and integer, integer, and it gives me boolean, so it'll be unsafe. So if we get it is rows, so y and x, unsafe array get index array is get index and advent unsafe maybe. And now so grid from list. Right, so let's see. Oops. Number of connected regions, read and node node, node contexts, needs arguments, and graph. So node context N E. So what is N and what is E? Node N. So node is label. I don't know. Node boolean. Okay. So this should probably be this. Now, so grid should be grid. Okay, and map works. And fold also works. Okay, and so array index map. So let's do some juggling. How to do it? So we have array of arrays. So append. So arrays will be what fold append. Yeah, Gristle. Nice to have you here, or nice to have had you here. So graph. So it does something. Number of connected regions. So does it mean we are getting something here? Yeah. Wow. Okay, I have no way to visualize this, but let's hope it works. And now, number of connected regions. So, or maybe let's just try to visualize this. Okay, it seems to do something. It looks like it could be right. So, graph. Now, let's just try strongly connected components. So, so, where are we? Is it right? It's list of components. So we can probably map error. So let's like this. Okay, case this thing of so the example failed. We got many more than we had to have. Okay. So, let's try it on something smaller. Let's try. Let's see, where can we get this? Let something be. Grid. So, maybe do it like this. And this will be find answer of like this. So let let's do it like this. True, true, false, false should be one group. Great, right. So right, sure. So for the sake of debugging, let's put it here. So yeah, sure, 128. I know I was wrong. Blank and and then we'll have to do it with IDs. And here. ID length. Okay. Array has length. Array has length. Unsafe maybe. So the answer is 3. I don't want 3. Right. So it's also maybe it's also taking the zeros, but it shouldn't, because the graph is only, or is not, the graph is not composed of the ones, the truths only. It's great. Make note context. So we have to filter. Oops. So row into array filter. Wait. So filter by cell, and cell has to be true. So it could be filtered by identity, but this is more readable. And okay, so this is wrong. This is better. Right, so one, that should be more correct. But we still have some issues. But we are getting closer. So one is all right. Now let's try to true, true, true. So we are spanning the vertical line. Okay, we are. Now let's do true. Colors shine through. Okay, false, true. This should be two. A cyclic graph. Okay, that's edge case that I don't have to think about, but well. So let's make it three-dimensional. Oh no, just three rows, three columns. So that should also be what? I thought it should be one. So how come? This should be one, but it's two. Okay, so we have a bug here. So, why is it like this? So I know what that looks like. The arrays are not probably doing any damage to that. But now, let So, where were we? Zero, zero is right. 0 1 is right, 1 1 is right, and shouldn't it be 1 2? It should, right? So, yeah. So we basically lost our position in there. So 1, 2. Okay, that's better. And the answer is 1, right? Awesome. So now let's try it again. Test passed. Great. So, at least that works. So, 1,000 groups. Hooray! So, we are done. Yeah, so, I think I got pretty, like, slowed down. I halted on like picking the representation and whether to use graphs or matrix or whatever. But in the end, it worked, and I am even a bit faster, like better rank. That's interesting. So let me just see my colleagues. Well, you have seen my session cookie. Oh no. didn't think about that. And yeah, so I am the first on part one, but last on part two. Wow, that's only 13 minutes between those. That's nice. So, okay, thank you for watching, and I will just. Why did I change? And no, I do not want to remove it, or do I? I do not. Come on. Okay, so day 10, right, hash, day 14, right, some new packages, and unset new. Great. So again, thanks for watching, and see you tomorrow.